Hey guys, Alex here from PMTV UK, and if you squint a little bit and maybe I take my glasses off, I look a little bit like that guy from that other hot sauce show. Welcome to Wham Wands, the show with wham questions and even whammer wings. I'm joined today by these two fine specimens. You know who they are already. We've got Dagan Wilkin and Megan Linford from PMTV UK. How's it going?
Very good, mate.
So we're in a bit of a weird scenario today. We're in the Newcastle studio and it's the end of 2022. We've had a wonderful year full of new music instrument releases, lots of new equipment. We've had travels, we've been here, there and everywhere. And so this is a perfect time for us to look back on the year and reflect on some of our favourite moments and some of your guys' favourite moments. And we thought we might as well mix things up a bit by having some vegan nuggets and some hot sauce, because who doesn't like to see some famous YouTube influencers suffer a little bit on camera?
Yes, while answering questions.
Yeah. So here we go. How are you guys with spicy food? Do you like spicy food?
I do like spicy food, but I don't want to stitch myself up too soon by saying I'm really good with it, but I do like it.
Yeah.
On the curry scale, I'm a korma.
Oh. That's Chicken not a good korma. Start,
But I do, when I'm in the US, I like to go to Tony Roma's and have the buffalo hot sauce chicken, like the chicken bits. That's as hot as I get.
Yeah, okay. Well, we've got a selection of sauces here. We're gonna obviously go up in ascending order, see what happens, and get your guys' thoughts on the year so far. You ready? Ready to do this?
Let's get into it.
Would you like to do the honors first, Mr. Wilkin?
Yes. Why the devil not?
It's always gone quite heavy there.
So I've got that. I'm gonna
look at this.
I'm gonna cover my nug.
Thank you.
I think this one should be quite nice.
At first, I thought you were being tactical and having it off to the side so that you could choose how much
to dip in,
but you're just absolutely smothering that.
Smothering it.
Great.
You only live once. Don't this?
Yeah, why not? Thanks.
This is the mild one, and it smells really spicy.
It's pretty pungent, isn't it? Yeah. Have you done both sides of yours?
I've just covered mine now.
Okay.
Cheers.
Cheers. Haha, that sucks. Oh no!
Well, this is not going to go great, is it? We're on number one. It's got, certainly got something to it.
Oh!
Nice.
Napkin, sir.
I'm worried about number four now.
Yep.
So your PMT content journey not only takes you up and down the UK, but all over the world too. Dagan, you've now been to the NAMM show in Los Angeles 5 times. And we've had, as I said earlier, lots of travels this year. What's been your favourite moment of 2022 in your PMT content creation journey?
I think my favourite highlight of the year was going to California with you guys, doing all the content over there, my standout bits from that trip, playing Prince's guitar.
Oh yeah.
That was really cool. Prince's actual guitar, Ed Schechter, who made the replicas that sold Prince's ones as well. And playing through Eddie Van Halen's guitar rig, which we can't disclose where it was, but you guys can confirm that it happened. I have a video on my phone, I'm not allowed to show anyone. But I played through one of Eddie's amplifier rigs from the 2015 World Tour, and it was mint. So that's my highlight of the year. Where are you, Meg?
Oh, it's definitely California. I mean, probably for me, it was the Taylor Factory.
You okay there, sir?
No. Oh, I was really hoping that wouldn't be as spicy as it is.
Yep.
Sorry, Megalake.
Let's just ignore him. Carry on.
Yeah, definitely the Taylor Factory, I think, was one of the main highlights of that trip. But that California trip, I've never even been to the States. So the amount we did on that trip and the amount of factories we went to, it was just incredible. So good.
What about you? I want to know. You were there as well. What was your favourite bit?
Oh, for sure. I mean, yeah, the answer is obviously the California trip. And like you say, we packed so much in. We got so much content. I think we had one day off in total. And we did work really hard. I know it looked like a holiday, but, you know, we were grafting
As soon
hard.
As we got up in the morning, we were filming and doing stuff and having to be here and everywhere. It was fun, though, but yeah.
Yeah.
It's hard graft.
Just everything over there. Like, you point a camera at something and it looks great. The scenery was amazing. All the factories were just, like, world class. The people were so nice, as they always are in the States. Yeah, it was just a great experience, and I'd love to do it again.
Yeah. Okay, so we're moving on to the next one now.
Moving on to the next one.
Oh, God.
2022 has seen all kinds of new releases from all of our favourite musical brands. What has been, for both of you guys, your most notable new release from this year?
Amp-wise, for me, it's the St. James, because I use them in all the videos. The 6L6 one's my favourite. It's just the really lightweight, all-valve amplifier that we all love from the videos. And guitar-wise, I'll have to have a think. Not you.
Well, I loved the when we were over in the Taylor factory, and Andy Powers had those two Koa guitars that were embargoed, and we couldn't get any pictures with them. When they came out and we got to play them, they were amazing. 724?
Yeah. Yeah,
all colour one. I loved that. I also really liked that Blue Jim Dandy, which I know is complete opposite level of guitars, but they did some different colours on the Jim Dandy Parlours, and I love the blue one. That was probably one of my favourites.
Most recently guitar-wise for me, where is it? The Adam Jones Les Paul Standard. That's an awesome thing. Big fan of that. He's got his customs and stuff, but it's just the Les Paul Standard with his profile neck, and it's an ebony fingerboard. So even if you're not a Tool fan, it's just a cool...
It's very cool.
Cool guitar. All right, so we're going to smash this second way.
Yeah, well, this one is... the first one was vibrant. This is beyond that. You know, it's got a... It's pretty red.
Oh, God.
Cheers.
Cheers.
You're going for the whole thing as well. Mm. Well done.
Mmm. That is banging.
That is good.
That's really nice.
That one, for me, isn't as...
No, it's coming.
Mmm. I will...
It's on its way. It's lingering, that one.
More stupid idea, I suppose.
I really like that.
You're going to get a train later as well.
Yeah.
For like 4 hours.
So this year saw the PMTV UK YouTube channel reach a whopping 300,000 subscribers. People from all around the world have watched your videos this year for a combined 1.2 million hours, and you've uploaded 377 videos so far. We're recording this in November, so it's going to be even higher. What's been your favourite video that each of you have made this year?
Besides all the obvious ones of all the American stuff, like George Tripp's, his workshop and...
Oh, that was great.
That was crazy because I love nerdy stuff like that. Last week I shot the Gibson 70s Flying V. That's the most fun I think I've had in a video for a long time. Just because the guitar is great. It's a big, stupid, white Flying V.
It's very you.
And it was just loads of fun. Didn't have to try, didn't... skip over any lines. I knew all the specs, and it was just the video was about one take all the way through, and I've just smiled throughout the entire thing. So that's a really big standout besides all the obvious awesome stuff we did in California. I'm struggling.
I think a couple of my favourites were, I did a couple of album, like a Joni Mitchell album and a Crosby, Stills and Nash album, Gear Rundown. That was so much fun. I just listened to the album on repeat for it was a good excuse to just sit at home and deep analyse an album. I loved making those and getting all the gear in that they used in the albums. Yeah, those two.
Again, 377 videos is a lot.
It is.
So I'll definitely be watching this back going, why didn't I mention X video? Why didn't I do that?
Yeah, give us a break if we forget some.
Instead of saying last week I did a Flying V and it was mint. Yeah. There's definitely more poignant ones than that, but for now, I mean, maybe check the comments for where I've commented going, this video is actually my favourite, but yeah.
What music gear surprised you the most this year?
I did I heard it first when we were in America, that Poly Blue pedal. We've had so many people playing it in the stores. That was fun. When I properly understood how it worked, and when we've had some bass players come in and play it in London, and it is such a fun pedal. I don't know if surprise is the right word for that, but I didn't know what it was before we got there.
It's one of them pedals that's kind of hard to describe what it does, but once you plug it in and get it going, you're like, oh,
it's like an octave generator. It sounds great when it's good, but it's really easy to get a bad sound out of it.
Exactly.
So unless you know what you're looking for, but when you nail it, it's something special that nothing else can recreate.
That's what I thought, yeah. It's really interesting.
I've also thought of my favourite video. The Sex Pistols Gear Guide.
Of course, yeah. That was a lot of fun.
Sex Pistols Gear Guide. Huge Sex Pistols fan, one of my favourite bands of all time, and one of the reasons I play guitar the way I do. We've got all the gear in. Gibson sent us up the Steve Jones Les Paul Custom, which was my dream guitar as a kid. I got to play that for a little bit and just basically have a whole day playing Sex Pistols songs, and it was mint. A piece of gear that surprised me was the Daddario pedal board that expands.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, good shout.
The expand pedal board. Because when I first saw it, I was like, that's a gimmick.
Yeah.
It's a gimmick and a half. How are they going to pull that off?
Yeah.
And I use one every weekend now, and I change it all the time, depending on how many pedals I need. And like, oh, that's fun. I don't need that this weekend. I'm going to put something else in there, make it bigger, make it smaller, put a Strymon on, put a small delay on, and stuff like that. I remember seeing it and being like, that's a dicey move, that. Dicey move. But yeah, I use one every weekend, and it's absolutely mint.
What music gear could you not live without? And maybe off the back of that, you could tell us pick one guitar, one amp, and one pedal. From your entire collection, everything you've played, you got to narrow it down to just one of each. What would you have?
Gibson SG Custom, a lovely white and gold one, because it's my dream guitar. Amp-wise, probably the St. James, because it's lightweight and you can carry it around, and it's all valve. And the clean sound is based off like a Fender amp, dirty sound. You can go from crunchy to death metal. And pedal-wise, Phase 90, just for constant Van Halen.
Well, obviously my Taylor 414, mm-hmm. I've got Strymon Blue Sky. I could gig without any other pedals, but that reverb pedal, yeah. I will always have that on my board. And I don't really use amps a lot, because I play mostly acoustics.
I think we're like in a big Mesa Boogie Jew rectifier stack.
Yeah, I was going to say, like a huge stack.
Huge no. Randall stack.
I'd actually sub that out and say my interface, yeah, the SSL I've got at home and my little home studio set up, I wouldn't be able to live without that. It's how I do all my songwriting, so probably not an amp, probably more that, I reckon.
So you'll be sat there recording, like doing proper musical stuff, and I'll just be playing Hocker Teacher in the corners. That's not what I do. Don't boil my entire career down to.
I live on the other side of music. It all sounds like that.
Yeah, very true, very true.
All right, well, should we step this up again? We've got two more, well, maybe three more sources to go. Come on. Let's take this up a notch again.
Can't swear.
I can bleep it out.
With this one, can we be a bit more sparing, or do you want us to just cover it still?
Cover it.
All right, cool.
Cover it.
You're backing out.
Ruin your day.
Not backing out. I was just checking.
Oh, you're making sure to really cover that. Yeah.
Absolutely, soaking yours.
Thanks.
I want to watch you cry asking these questions because you never get to go on camera because you're always just there. It's
quite literally trial by fire. Well, thanks for that, mate.
Chin chin.
Chin chin.
Gonna kick in, isn't it?
This one has more of a scent to it, I think.
I hate this.
Oh. It's a different. Yeah.
How?
I can see tears.
I don't like this tears at all. This is a horrible game. We've even got a sick bucket for Meg, but it's for me now because I'm gonna be sick. Oh, that's grim.
I don't know if it's just not hit me yet, but that...
I think you're just hard as nails. Mm.
So your guys' jobs didn't exist 10 years ago, or maybe even less. Full-time YouTubers and appearing on camera for millions of people around the world, in the US to Australia to everywhere. What are your reflections looking back on how your careers have evolved and what the future may hold?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think I'm peaking here. This is me. I'm all downhill from here. Yeah. Unless the real Short Evans wants to have a chat with her. This is me peeking. Sorry, Meg.
Oh no, that's right. We were actually talking about this last night because we both kind of fell into this, so it's been a really interesting journey. I would never have expected when I took the job as an acoustic guitar salesperson in a shop to end up in Hot Wings with you guys and making videos.
I don't think
videos.
Any of us expected this.
No. I thought it was a great idea, you know.
Yeah, it was your idea. yeah, it's a really interesting and cool part of the industry to have fallen into, so I'm pretty grateful. Hopefully it'll just get bigger and better, the channel, and although I imagine it will.
But. Yeah, it's awesome. Yeah, I'm extremely grateful to everyone watching this and who subscribed and likes and comments and follows us on Instagram and follows buys through PMT and all the rest, because it's a bit of a roller coaster ride. If you don't know how it all started, when I started working here at the PMT Newcastle store, just doing videos and stuff, selling guitars and stuff, Alex brought his camera in one day and was like, let's film some guitar stuff. Or what was the first thing we filmed?
It was it was an amp. I'll show the people now.
Don't, because I'm all skinny.
Mate, come on.
I'm all way.
Hey, this is Dagan from Newcastle. Here's a short demo of two Strymon pedals, the Blue Sky and the El Capistan, with a custom 24 PRS and an American Standard Strat, through the clean channel of a JVM 205.
You did have a certain, like, I'm too cool for school
thing.
Yeah. I mean, you are too cool for school still.
Mint. I thought, oh, but it was very like,
hey, I'm Dagan, and this is the clean channel of a Marshall. Da, da, da. Oh, yeah. And then it was like, I think one of the guys from the head office just kind of rang us and said, do you want to do this a little bit more? Like, if you've got some spare time in the... Mm-hmm. During your day.
Yeah.
Then we did the EVH one, like you say, where we turned the lights off in the guitar room, put a strobe light on, got you to play some Van Halen.
We didn't put a strobe light on, I'm sure one of them was as well, was Thomas McCrocklin, who was there with a Parkan light.
Yes.
Just doing this.
Yeah.
So it wasn't a strobe light, it looked like a strobe light, but it was just getting hoed about to give it the effect.
And yeah, it just went from there.
That's that, well, that went viral.
It did,
and that's
yeah.
What made the bosses go, good that.
Yeah.
Do more. And now here we are.
Here we are. It's kicking in a bit on the lips.
Spreading.
Like, mm-hmm. Yeah, I can feel it on my lips.
Mm-hmm. What's the most poignant musical memory of your life?
Jesus Christ.
Wow.
You do that, and I will get the next one ready.
Oh, that's a deep question.
Probably the what made me want to play guitar.
Yeah, I was watching, thinking something like that.
My dad had a VHS tape of AC/DC playing Donington Park, Monsters of Rock. There's a, I think they're playing Thunderstruck, and Angus Young goes out on the long thing, the long walkway, and it's just him with the SG, and you can see the horns at a silhouette, and it just looks, I was like, that's the coolest thing in the world, I want to do that. So that's the most poignant thing in my head. That and seeing Eddie Van Halen play for the first time on a video and thinking, how the hell do you do that? And I thought it was the guitar, I thought it was the Kramer, and that's why I love Kramer so much, because I thought it was the guitar, not Eddie. That's when I seen it for the first time, being like, what's that? That's ridiculous, that's not real. Yeah, that's a lot of sauce, that, Alex, son.
Well, you know.
Yeah, you poured heavy on that one. Well, it's the same sort of time, I'd say. I remember the first gig I went to. I got like a free ticket off an art teacher when I was 14 to go to this random folk gig. Got this woman called Kate Rusby, and it blew my mind. I remember that from that day on, I got myself an acoustic guitar. I was like, I want to do that. That's probably the most poignant one. I remember it really well.
Nice.
Yeah.
What was yours? Because he's a guitar player as well. What,
oh, that is a good question.
Something to do with Muse, and you wearing red pants.
To be fair, yeah, that is quite a good one. It was before I'd even picked up a guitar, and seeing Muse playing, like, not Top of the Pops, but some kind of like show where they had live music on, and they had they were playing Hysteria, and that was the first Muse song I heard. And it's probably my favourite to this day. And they had like the laser sort of light show going on. He has his ridiculous Manson, which was probably the mirror one with like
the DeLorean or the mirror
one, something
two,
like
yeah.
that, one of his many Mansons. And from then I was like, this is awesome, I haven't heard anything like this before, I think it's musically really interesting. And that was it.
I
was
sorry, I had a hot flush while you were chatting and I got goosebumps. It wasn't anything that you said was very
oh, it wasn't my
didn't kind of
answer,
hit
really.
Home. I just kind of went fell inside of myself for a second when you were talking.
Well, speaking of such things, we're approaching the end now, people. You're doing really well.
Thanks.
Thank you.
So let's
this is not tomato ketchup. Please be warned.
This comes with a warning. Great.
Okay, must be good.
Excellent.
Can I do yours again, Alex?
Yeah, sure.
This train journey is going to be mint. Meg, I'll do yours as well.
Not that one.
Not that one.
It's that one. Oh,
you're double upping. There we go. Look at that.
Okay. Approaching the end. Cheers.
Thank
chin
you.
Chin.
It's going to creep up on us again.
No, mine's here.
Sorry, what? Oh no.
It's on the side. It's on the sides of my tongue. It's like round the bottom. How's it there? Where's my emergency water?
I like it.
What advice have you got for new and aspiring musicians? What are some of the key lessons that maybe you wish you guys had known when you first started playing an instrument?
My, that's always a fit.
Do you want me to talk while you recoup?
No.
Okay.
Meg's an absolute pro at this.
I really enjoyed that.
It's like Lords. You ever seen Lords? Just smashes through them.
Mm-hmm.
There's two things I feel like. One is like serious and sensible, and it's genuinely consistency is important, and you have to practice. And I've gone through so many stages where I've dipped in and out of that, and you got to practice. But also, make sure that you express yourself. That's why we make music. How you doing, Dagan?
I wholly agree with everything you've just said.
can't
agree more. For me, it's hard, you know, to talk. I always just tell people to stand up.
That's all we're saying. That's all you're getting, people.
Advice for people, play guitar standing up more, because it's a lot harder to play guitar standing up than it is sitting down. And people, especially who are just starting out, want to play gigs and stuff, really good sitting down. When you stand up, you want to have the guitar low. Unless you want to have it high, that's totally fine. But a lot of people want to have a low. It's a totally different ball game. That and also practice in the dark or in low light. Because when you get on stage, sometimes it's dark and there's not a lot of lights and stuff. So practice with the lights off, standing up. There's more to it than that. But I can't.
Nah, yeah. less of a percentage of digging today.
No. This is awful. Why are you fine? I don't like
my
this.
Lips are tingling, but...
It's in the back of my tongue. It's under.
But no, my mouth is fine.
You just made your SG resonate. So some musicians have famously said things like, it's not about what music you use, it's all about the music itself. And some musicians have even completely separated themselves from any kind of lasting affiliation with musical instrument brands. But you guys clearly see the value and importance of having the right equipment for the job, and you've already talked about some of your favourites. Could you describe in your own words the importance and significance of musical instruments as a whole?
It would be a very bleak, sad world without music and musical instruments. I know that much. Mm.
It'd be a really bleak and sad world without instruments. Meg?
Back to me. Yeah, they're just, I mean, we're biased because we are musicians, so they're so important to all of us, but I feel like giving kids the opportunity to play an instrument from being young is something that everyone should have, because it's just, like I said, it just makes the world a better place, music.
Yeah, especially playing, making music, like,
yeah,
especially guitar, like with your hands, as opposed to with your feet, or your knees.
He's really struggling there. The mental cognition's not quite working.
Because, like, when I'm in a good mood, I play guitar. When I feel sad, I play guitar. When I want to pass an hour, I play guitar. Yeah. If I'm really busy, I'll play guitar just to kind of, like, unwind and, like, decompress. So it's a great thing. Even if you're not, like, necessarily playing music or anything, just to, like, make
switch
stuff,
off.
Something happen that wasn't previously there. Vibrations in the air and all that kind of stuff. Vibrations in my mouth. Something that might answer your question. That's sort of
well. You did well, yeah, well done.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, we weren't sure whether we were going to do this because we weren't sure how hot these hot sauces were going to be, but I think it's time to break out the big guns. In the fridge, we've got a very famous, very, very hot sauce. One more question to ask you guys.
Yeah.
Are you ready? Should we escalate?
Can you ever be ready for that? I don't think so. I think we've just got to do it.
The worst things I ever done was when I was 18 years old, I got Carpe Diem tattooed on my chest to seize the day. So let's have some more hot sauce.
I'm nervous about this one.
Oh, it's pungent, man.
Well, like I said before, I'm having a roller coaster of emotions. I'm happy, I'm sad, I'm confused. I'm impressed, I'm unhappy. I don't know where I sit right now, but this is going to ruin my day, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. It's going to be bad.
Yeah, there's so much paper on the phone now, it's like we're in a rabbit hutch.
It's okay though, because the bucket's empty.
Oh, the bucket's empty, Meg.
So this is Da Bomb. I'm sure you'll have seen this before.
It's beyond insanity.
Beyond insanity. Whether you've experienced it is a different matter. It is an experience.
The best thing about this as well is the fact that Alex has had it for ages and there's loads left and it's out of date.
Oh,
that's
nice.
How good it is.
Only buy a bit, don't worry. Well, I hope you enjoy it.
It's going to be great. I think we should, for this final one, Andy.
Yeah.
If you want to come, Andy or Drew, people might know him as Drew, is our content lead.
Behind the scenes. Hero.
I was trying to say something really like fun, like such and such, but come here,
get yourself
smash
there.
This wing with
wow.
So this is like black, isn't it? Look at tiny Meg's bit. This is like black.
Yeah,
tart.
It's
this one.
That's the one. So are you gonna go? Are you gonna go straight in with Da Bomb? Are you gonna introduce yourself to any of the other ones first, or?
As Degan said, Carpe Diem.
Let's just crack on, shall we?
Let's just crack on. Right.
Yeah, okay,
right.
Get yourself.
How
on,
much,
man.
Alex?
Oh, mate, much. Just.
That's fine, man.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna eat the whole thing, so I don't want to like mask it. I'm just gonna like bite the tip.
Okay, that's a good shout.
Yeah. Oh God, this is gonna suck.
All right.
It's fine. Thanks to everyone who subscribes to PMTV UK. We love you all. I hate Alex, even though we've been good friends for years. This is a stupid idea. Why did he bring that from his bloody fridge? You just moved house as well. That could have went in the bin. Yeah. Rollercoaster of emotions.
See you on the other side.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh.
Oh, here it comes. Oh.
Yeah, it's that one's hit my throat. First one.
Come on.
Oh.
He's going in again.
No, that is.
It's not best about you. Come on.
I can feel that one.
It's
it's here.
I've just done something very unwise.
Ah, Ah, the water doesn't help.
No, I'll make it worse.
Ah, you got me there.
Dagan and Meg, it's been another year of amazing content. You've come this far, you've climbed the mountain. Spicy food fan and definitely not a spicy food fan. Everyone's a winner here. Now is your challenge though. Final challenge of 2022. Dagan and Meg, can you please each teach us your favourite riff? Grab a guitar. Grab your guitar of choice.
I don't play riffs.
Your favourite song then.
What? I've got an amp.
Well, that's what he thinks of that. Oh. Well done.
Meg, hurry up, is that your favourite riff or what?
No. Crack on. Please do. Riffing is not my game.
Enlighten us.
Favourite riff.
Oh, he's struggling.
It's
getting so much worse.
Girls, Girls, Girls by Motley Crue. Or Riff Raff by AC/DC. Oh, right. What now? What do I do to stop it, Alex?
Tell the people what you've got going on in your life. Where can they see more ridiculous content like this?
I've got a lot going on right now. Speaking about what's going on in my life, a lot's happening currently. Meg?
Social medias, I guess. YouTube.
You know? The stuff.
My tongue is burning.
Thank you to everyone who subscribed. More stuff, so do you have better and better for next year? We've got some rad stuff planned.
We do.
I'm Dagan Wilkin on Instagram. If you want to give us a follow?
Megan Linford Music is my handle. Thank you all so much. It's been such a good year. Such a good year. My tongue is on fire.
Are you taking the reins and ending this video, Meg?
Maybe. How are you all doing?
If you can you wrap this shit up, please?
All right, thank you so much for watching and thank you so much for everything this year. Thank you, Alex, for that ridiculously hot sauce and
anytime.
For bringing us into this ridiculously stupid video. Andy, thank you for joining. Dagan, you're a trooper. I think we all need to go lie down.